Elmaz Abinader. Would any of us be here today if not for her? I know I wouldn't. I wouldn't be at VONA. I wouldn't be in California. And if I say everything I want to say, I'll start crying, so I'm just going to stick to the script. Co-founder of VONA, she has published such works as Children of the Rujmi, In the Country of My Dreams. Her plays include Country of Origin and Ramadan Moon. She teaches at Mills College. I love the understatement of that. She teaches at Mills College. She runs the place. By the way, she's the teacher. I've never seen anyone teach with such skill and generosity. I co-taught with her at VONA. I've seen her teach at Mills, and she even dragged me to the Y and kicked my butt.
Countries, ranges peaking across the Urals, frozen tundra, pampas, veld, thickly populated cities, railroad tracks. I run my finger along each symbol, each road designation, each color, each touchstone. How do you mark a barrier, make it part of a landscape? What is the symbol of restraint? This is not the wall of the Great March, just the slow death to the earth that inhabits it and the people who make it home. This is a poem for my brother-in-law and my sister. And I've been surrounded my whole life about questions of faith. We grew up super Catholic. Super Catholic. We went to church every day. We learned the Latin Mass. Then I lived in Islamic countries, and I observed Ramadan. I still do to this day. But I'm a non-subscriber, I say. We went through an experience in the family this year that made me understand something about faith. And this one's called, That Isn't Faith, This Is. You listen more attentive than most. Take mental notes of where the knife will enter your chest, where the underground routes to your heart have jammed and need a bulldozer to clear the way, replace the cables, resurge the flow. And you tell it all like a good story you heard maybe from the person sitting next to you on the plane with pictures, arrows, and instructions. And I find it funny that of all the ideologies that move through our lives, the gods, false and the divine, the mantras and rosaries, the litanies and songs, the literatures and dogmas, we pray for that night to hit right, to not stray, for the steadiness of the hand that slips a vessel from your leg into your chest, that connects the tubes like a master pipe fitter. It's a lot to expect from someone and not God you may not or may believe in, someone who learns your name ever so briefly, doesn't know what your heart means and to whom. I call it faith, letting yourself sleep surrounded by people you don't know, giving your body to their hands, exposing the contents of your heart the way you have to so few or so many. And I hope that your heart in their hands knows the kindness that strangers give to one another in brave circumstances, floods, births, confusions, and fear. This is all we can believe, that you may return refueled and cloudless, love replaced with love, a heart comes stronger. Thank you.